welcome back. I hope you've had a really good Christmas, those that I haven't seen or caught up with so far. All you wanted, all you wished for, and then you also remembered the assembly that Mr. Brunton did before Christmas about what the meaning of Christmas is and what it's all about. We're lucky enough to have Mr. Brunton in again today to do our assembly, so can we give him a big Year 7
and a happy new year to you. I thought what I would do today is, because it's the start of the new year and I'm sure you've all made resolutions and most of you will have broken them already, but just to remind you a little bit about some of the messages we were talking about before the Christmas break. I'm going to start by playing an old classic song. Right. Listen to the words, they're not that clear to pick out, but you might be able to pick out the main sort of thing. The respect campaign in the school for all sorts of good reasons, but it really does start by respecting yourself. If you can't respect yourself, then it's difficult to respect other people, and it's difficult for other people to respect you. So that's the starting point. I'm going to pick out some of the words from that song for you.
He said,
to start getting self-respect, one of the lines there is, if you disrespect other people, that normally means you don't respect yourself, that you're not going to be able to have self-respect. So if you're always putting other people down, it normally is an indicator that you don't have self-respect because you're trying to put other people down below you. And a second phrase is, if you do that, then they're not going to respect you. It's a bit complicated, this sort of goes in a circle. So that again makes you respect yourself less. So to get self-respect, it comes from other people, a lot of it, as well as coming from inside you. So that's one line from the song, or two lines from the song. A couple of other lines from the song. These are things that, if you have these, you're less likely to have self-respect. So, if you expect to get your own way all the time, it's normally a sign that you don't respect yourself. Because you just demand from people all the time, and you're not doing things from yourself, for yourself. If you think the world owes you something, if you think you're just going to sit there and somebody's going to come along and give you your GCSE results, or they might come along and say, oh, you look a nice person, there's a job, and you'd like a new car? Yeah, of course, here, there's a new car. If you have that attitude, then you're not going to be able to respect yourself. And I'll come back to why. So those two things. If you want your own way all the time, you won't be able to respect yourself. And if you expect people to just give you everything you want in life, you won't be able to respect yourself. And there's a reason for that. And we'll come back to it. So I've just put up some key words there of how do you get self-respect. Well, you get self-respect by having good manners. Because if you're well-mannered, people will respect you for that. If you say it after you, if you say good morning, if you let somebody sit down in the canteen when they're running out of seats instead of you, people will look at you and think, what a nice person. And that will make you feel good about yourself. That's where this self-respect comes from, because you're doing a good thing. Using good language. You know when you're not using good language, but so do other people. And they think, oh, that language is dreadful. And you pick up on that and you think, although you keep using it because you think it might be cool or hard or whatever it is nowadays, you know deep inside it's not the right thing to do. So again, you start disrespecting yourself. This is the one that links to those last two on the slide before. Being successful gives you a lot of self-respect. And you can be successful from being a good person to becoming the Prime Minister and everything in between. But by being successful, you know inside yourself you're doing well. And that's where that respect comes from. So if you expect somebody to give you your GCSE results and you've done nothing for them, they don't mean anything. You've worked hard and you get them, really makes you feel good inside. And it really makes you respect yourself because you know you've achieved it. If you're going to go, you can afford to go out and buy yourself a new car, you know you've earned that money. You know you've been successful in your job or whatever it happens to be. That gives you a bit of self-respect. So the success one is a really important thing about building up self-respect, and another way of phrasing that, self-esteem. Something I mentioned before Christmas, just being good. Because if you're a good person, people reflect that back to you. And it makes you feel good about yourself. And I suppose linked to the being good is doing the right thing. If you can do the right thing every time, you will have pride in you. And that's where this whole respect thing starts. Some people lose it. Some people don't achieve it. There's some images of people who have lost their own self-respect for whatever reason. And there are all sorts of reasons why people lose self-respect. It can be relationships breaking down. It can be influenced by drugs or alcohol. It can help. It may be about employability. You've not been able. You've left school and what have you? You've not done very well. Nobody will give you a job. You've got no money. How do I get it? I might nick a bit of money from here and there. And you end up in prison. And nobody will work with you. And you just lose so much respect for yourself. You give up on yourself. Some of it can be illness, to be fair. One of the sad things is, if any of you went into the city over the Christmas period, you could see people like this, sitting in doorways, normally with a pile of blankets, and for some strange reason, very often a dog. Don't want. But that's what happens when self-respect goes. That's what happens to people. On the other side of the coin, successful people being successful and images of success. Skip through that one. You'd look at those pictures and say, yeah, successful people, they're doing really well. Loads of self-respect. Look at the difference in the images. Completely different place in their lives to those people who we were looking at on a previous projection. This is a poster I found. It's produced by a psychologist. These, those are people who sort of know stuff about what's going on inside your head. And this poster, on one side, over here, this is what unsuccessful people, this is their traits. This is how they can behave. Not everything on there, but lots of the things on there. And the traits of successful people are over here. I'll just read out one or two of them. Unsuccessful people. Criticize others. Unsuccessful people hold a grudge and don't forgive, one of those Christmas things. Unsuccessful people have a sense of entitlement. In other words, that's that thing, you owe me a living. You better give me something without me having to earn it. But they feel that's where they are. Unsuccessful people take all the credit from other people when things do go right, instead of sharing it out. That's just some of them over here. Some of them are quite technical. Successful people, on the other hand, successful people compliment other people. They forgive other people. They give other people credit when things do go well. They accept responsibility when things don't go well. Something doesn't work, instead of saying it was her, I say, actually, I know, that was my fault. I'm ever so sorry. But it's interesting as you go down the list, the different traits. And this idea of self-respect being linked directly to being successful as a human being, not necessarily in your job, but just as a human being, can make a huge difference to how you feel about yourself, how therefore other people feel about you, and how successful you are in your life. So my message for you this morning at the start of 2014 is think about those traits, those things that you have to do to be successful. Then start feeling good about yourself. And then suddenly you'll find everybody else starts feeling good about you. And I'll leave you where we started.
creative writing, writing stories, maybe writing stories for competitions, things like that, because I know some of you are really keen on writing in here. The other club is being run by Liz Jones, and that one is a Tuesday tea party, she's calling it, and it is focused on helping you improve your literacy, okay? So it's helping you if you feel like you need to move on in a level, she will help you and give you a bit of extra support for that. So there's two different clubs happening on Tuesdays, and you can choose if you'd like to come to one of them, but you do need to come to either me or Miss Jones and get a letter, and get your parents to sign that letter. I've got my pile of letters, and a couple of people have asked me already, and I'm going to be at the top of the stairs with Mr. Simiter, so a great time, so if you want to come and get one from me then. Miss Jones is in her room for the rest of the day. If we don't get many people, we'll combine them and we'll work together, but we're hoping to have two good groups doing slightly different things to do with their English and on Tuesday, so they are after school, 3:10 to 4 o'clock, both of those clubs, one in my room, one in Miss Jones' room. So you need to think, would I like to join one of those clubs? If so, come see me or Miss Jones to get a message.
And that fits really nicely what Mrs. Swain has just said there about respecting yourself and acknowledging that you might have an area that you need to develop in your literacy. If your English teacher set you a literacy target and you want to go and get extra help on, you respect yourself, you get better, you go and help, you go and get the help that you need, and you improve and you get you become a successful person. So I would urge every single person to have a think about those two after school clubs that we have got going on. I continue to be proud of you, Year 7. Well done. Remember last year I said that our attendance was the best in the school and the number of send-outs is the best in the school. That has continued this week. Brilliant. Well done. Thank you. The two areas I would like you all to focus on, and I'm emailing your tutors every day now with a list of people that are late and people that do not have the correct equipment for school. There's not one person on your case now, there is one plus one other person who is making sure that you are prepared for school, and we get those two components to be the best in the school as well. And then we can go in with our heads held high and say, actually, Mr. Brunton, we are the best year group in the academy. Because, and here's the evidence. So make sure you're prepared for school with the correct uniform and the correct equipment, and make sure that you are here on time. Your form tutors and I are going to be really working hard with you to make sure that happens. Always like to give out some certificates. So these were the last two that we didn't get done at the end of last term. So an accelerated reader star, Abby Taggart, can you come forward and collect your certificate, please? You've got 175.3 points. Well done. Can we have your round of applause? Billy Kersley, 86.2% over 12 quizzes. Well done, Billy. Can you give Billy a round? Covering up his untouched shirt. Well done, Billy.
Brilliant.
Congratulations. Well done. Give Billy another round.